From the Gulf Coast to the mountains of West Texas, biologists have followed to the best of their abilities the habits and lives of Texas wildlife. Now scientists can better pinpoint exactly where wildlife travels by using the newest GPS technology. From 12,000 miles above the Earth, satellites are helping us track wildlife with detail and ease. Each spring, Kemp's Ridley sea turtles come to the Texas shore to perform one of nature's wonders by laying their eggs. Months later, their young hatch and begin their journey through life. Every new hatchling gives hope that this endangered species won't go extinct. The mothers have long since returned to the sea, but their exact whereabouts a mystery, until now.
We're conducting this tracking because we want to get an idea about the habitat usage by these adult females. We want to see where they're going in the marine environment, which is where they spend the vast majority of their life, where they're going for migration, as well as for foraging when they're done nesting. We are affixing satellite transmitters to Kemp's Ridley turtles that nested on the Texas coast, so we can follow their migratory pathways and look for any foraging hotspots in the Gulf of Mexico.
Once the turtle is in her trance while she's actually laying eggs, we will take a swipe sample from her carapace, and then we will put her in a transport vehicle and take her a brief ride to the turtle laboratory at Padron National Seashore. We put a little towel over the eyes of the turtle because sometimes this helps to calm the turtle. She will have a blood sample that is withdrawn, and there will be small biopsy tissue samples taken for use with various studies.
We have to sand the shell. We put down the first layer of the epoxy, which is cool as it dries, and then we'll affix the transmitter. Then when it's on there very well and solid, we will paint the surface to help prevent barnacles from adhering onto that area where it has been applied. The whole process takes about 3 hours. Every time we release a turtle, it is a meaningful experience to us. This is an endangered species. We want to make sure that it's released back on the beach in very healthy and vigorous condition. Many people have been involved in conservation work for Kemp's Ridley turtles. It's a cooperative effort that makes it special, and it's one step closer towards hopefully recovering the species someday so that it can be enjoyed by future generations.
The public can actually see the tracks for these nesting turtles. They go to www.seaturtle.org and look for the Padron National Seashore Kemp's Ridley Tracking Project. And then they will see a map for all of the turtles that we're tracking for this year's transmitters deployed. And then they will be able to actually click on the links to the specific turtles and see the individual maps.
Over 500 miles away in the mountains of West Texas, another species fights to survive. Historically, the native Texas desert bighorn sheep occurred in about 16 mountain ranges. But by the early 1960s, they were gone, mostly due to unregulated hunting and disease. Texas Parks and Wildlife and others have worked to restore the bighorns to their native Texas mountain ranges. But capturing and tracking these elusive animals is challenging in this vast West Texas desert.
The way we capture these is through a net gun and a helicopter. And what they do is they'll go out and somewhat selectively route them in the direction that they want, and then they fire a net gun on them. They fly up and they bank and they come back and they turn around, and it's almost like a fast-paced roller coaster ride. We have sources, in-state sources now that we can go to and capture from and relocate to other mountain ranges. You look up at the mountain and here you see the bubble of the helicopter, and then you see the thing attached at the bottom, and you know they're sheep. And as they get closer, there they are. Once at the processing station, they're aged.
You want to take a picture of the teeth?
Yeah.
You take fecal samples. They also take blood samples.
Four plus or four?
Four plus.
And those radio collars are there to help us monitor the bighorns.
GPS, 0434.
So that's where we get movement and identify other variables such as travel corridors. The restoration effort has been going on for more than 50 years, and you know it's now paying off, where we have surplus populations, you know, they're thriving.
Wow.
We're almost halfway there. Our goal is to have all of the 15 or 16 mountain ranges that have critical habitat for them to have bighorns. It wasn't a couple hours ago that they were at Elephant Mountain. Now here they are in their new home. Now they'll be here for the public to enjoy. And that to me is wonderful. Our satellite collars that we have now have really kind of amped up our game as far as technology goes, because they allow us to monitor bighorn movements pretty much real time. You can watch them anywhere in the world. And it's pretty fascinating how they move from one place to another. We see that ram, he crosses into Mexico, travels down the mountaintops quite a good ways, at least 25 miles from the release site. The ewes kind of doing their thing, staying around pretty close to the release site within a 7-mile radius. Really, really interesting how they move like that. Satellite collars will play a key role in the future.
Biologists now learn more about our native and endangered wildlife faster and easier than ever before. And the more we know, the better and smarter we can work to conserve our wildlife for future generations.